It gives me great pleasure to welcome the Honorable President of India, and we are very grateful to him as he has agreed to inaugurate the first INA Engineers Conclave. Sir, Indian National Science Academy of Engineering is a professional body of engineers. A few selected ones are selected who have made a significant difference to the society as fellows of the INAE. Its primary objective is to encourage and promote the pursuit of excellence in the field of engineering in all branches and all aspects of engineering. INAE undertakes research studies on important topics of national issues and prepares comprehensive documents on aspects of policy, future trends, etc. Some of these studies include impact of research on chemical industries, impact of R&D on Indian mining industry, performance, success and gaps in our metallurgical R&D efforts, etc. INAE has constituted 5 forums to analyze the status of the technology and come up with policy recommendations. These are engineering education, microelectronics, energy, technology foresight and management, engineering interventions in disaster mitigation. INAE also takes up various research schemes. With AICTE, it has launched an AICTE INAE Distinguished Professor Scheme, which encourages engineers in the industry to give lectures in the academic institutions to bring the industry and academy together. A reverse scheme was also launched where faculty from engineers or engineering institutions which interacts with the various industries. The effort of the INAE, sir, is more to focus more and more on problems of common man in India, and it is in this direction the concept of engineering conclave has been evolved. We are happy that we are organizing this engineering conclave in the week of Engineers Day in India, which is celebrated on 15th of September every year. And we do plan to organize this conclave everywhere, preferably coinciding this week of the Engineers Day. It is our wish, sir, that the Honorable President of India graces the conclave every year in different parts of the country. Sir, your gracious presence today will motivate the engineering community to dedicate themselves for national cause. Once again, I heartily welcome on behalf of the INAE organization of the EC 2013 DRDO, and we thank you very much, sir, for your gracious presence today for the and opening the Engineers Conclave 2013. Thank you.
It's my pleasure to welcome Honorable President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, for the inaugural function of the first Engineers Conclave today at Vigyan Bhavan. For the engineers, it's a historic day as we are starting a new chapter in the history of INAE, and perhaps also for the country, as we believe this initiative of INAE is going to be a game changer. On the Engineers Day, 15 September, we had successfully flight tested the long-range Agni 5 missile, an engineering feat. Today, we are inaugurating Engineers Conclave 2013 to further harness the vast potential of Indian engineering community represented here. INAE is a body of eminent engineers of the country who have made significant contributions in various fields of engineering. However, academies normally live in their own world of excellence in science and technology with feeble connection to the public or society. We at INAE want to change that perception, and the Engineers Conclave is an attempt in that direction. Planned to be an event of national importance every year, the Engineers Conclave aims to bring policy, perspective, technology initiatives, innovation, and industry on a common platform. The year 2013 has been a laudable year in Indian aerospace history. With the Agni 5 launch, Arihant criticality, Mars mission planned in October, LCO operationalization round the corner, India is ready to take its new role in technology leadership. Its INA's endeavor to come up with specific ideas and solutions that will change the life of the population, mitigate the daily risk of storm surges, tsunamis that may sweep them into the sea while maintaining the eco-balance of the region. I hope the conclave will come out with specific recommendations in that direction and bring new development for this area. We have a number of very senior and eminent engineers from all over the country who have come to participate in the conclave. We have industry leaders, we have the engineering leaders, and we have the scientific community with us. I wish all of them to actively deliberate on the themes and suggest how to improve further the conclave and the outcomes. So we are greatly honored by your presence and would seek your presence in Engineers Conclave to come in future also. Thank you, sir.
I am grateful to Dr. Baldev Raj, President INAE, Shri Avinash Chandar and Dr. Goyal for inviting me to this Engineers Conclave 2013. The Indian National Academy of Engineering is very active with many academic programs, as you heard just now from Dr. Goyal. But this idea of a conclave to address important societal issues which can be tackled through interventions by the engineering community, as explained by Shri Avinash Chanda, is a new major initiative of INAE. The two themes that have been chosen for this conclave, production and manufacturing in aerospace and engineering interventions in Sundarbans, make an interesting combination, indicating the national ambition for inclusive growth. And it is a privilege for all of us, fellows of the Academy, for the Honorable President to be with us today. The three main sectors of the Indian economy, agriculture, manufacturing, and the services sectors, are all important to us. Of course, food and nutritional security must be assured first. The services sector is equally important. The export-oriented IT services sector has created wealth for the country, and this should continue. But national development and national security, which I have considered two sides of the same coin, are strongly dependent on the manufacturing sector. There are strategic sectors ranging from aerospace, defense, and nuclear to cybersecurity, which require indigenization of modern products and systems. And we also need strong manufacturing capabilities in the MSME and rural sectors. All enterprises benefit from interaction with academia, but the approaches have to be different for large enterprises, the MSMEs, and for rural enterprises. When I was chairman of TIFAC of DST, we decided to upgrade the technologies of what I call technologically homogeneous MSME clusters by providing research development innovation support through a proximate academic institution. There are maybe 80 such technologically homogeneous clusters, MSME clusters in India. For example, in Howrah, there is a foundry cluster of perhaps 150 micro enterprises. And Jadavpur University is providing RDI support to them under this TIFAC program. Jadavpur University is also providing RDI support to the surgical instruments cluster in Barivipur. For rural enterprises, Gandhian economics is needed. Products based on improved technology for the rural population must be manufacturable and maintainable in the rural areas themselves. they could be sold in urban areas so that the money flows into villages. If the improved technology products are made outside and brought into villages, money flows out of the villages. The Sundarbans, with its unique geography and ecology, with its freshwater swamp forest and its mangroves, would require specially designed engineering interventions. We are in the midst of the third industrial revolution, which is being driven by the internet. We have our own national knowledge network. It's also driven by digital manufacturing or additive manufacturing, robotics, and other advanced technologies. Complicated parts in additive manufacturing or 3D printing technology can be manufactured by slicing their 3D model into thin layers and then depositing these layers. The manufacturing process can be customized. The information on the project can be obtained from through the internet. And most importantly, the manufactured parts can be in small numbers, because in additive manufacturing, the problem of economy of scale does not come here. The US National Academy of Engineering, in a spring 2012 document, has said that additive manufacturing has the potential to revolutionize the production of aerospace and defense components. My office is planning to bring together the scientists and engineers, and also companies interested in this field, particularly in high-end additive manufacturing, for a brainstorming session. And I'll be very happy if the Indian National Academy of Engineering can partner us in this effort. Thank you very much.
I'm happy to be here to inaugurate this Engineering Conclave 2013, being held for the first time in our country. It gives me pleasure to be amongst top engineers and technologists from all over the country who have gathered to share their innovative ideas and research and development work in diversified areas of engineering and technology. It is befitting that the present conclave is being jointly organized by the Indian National Academy of Engineering, the top engineering academy of the country, and our leading research organization, the Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO. The two themes, first, manufacturing of aerospace systems, and second, transforming Sundarban through engineering interventions, are apt and timely. Engineers play a very important role in every walk of life. They convert knowledge of basic sciences into products. They are versatile minds who build bridges between sciences, technology, and society. Engineers contribute to the nation's technological and industrial progress. They help improve living conditions for the common people. By virtue of our achievements in multiple fields, India stands poised to emerge as a leading nation in the 21st century. The innovation capability of our scientists and engineers will play a critical role in enabling India to achieve this goal. This conclave is happening at a time when the world is beginning to emerge from the global economic crisis. Though India's economic growth has declined in the recent time, I am confident we will be able to bring this deceleration into a halt and revert to the high growth levels that we attained in the past. I believe the underlying growth impetus remains strong due to continued rise in per capita income, expanding middle class consumers, and a young and energetic workforce. Of course, stronger efforts from all stakeholders can build on this trend and enable us to secure faster growth as global economy revives. India's engineering industry has been given by intersectoral linkage and proactive government policies. Special initiatives have been taken to support key subsectors with policies dedicated to automotive, electronics, chemicals and petrochemicals, and heavy machinery, among others. Clusters and growth corridors across the country facilitate competitiveness as centers such as Pune and Chennai and Bengaluru have attained global acclaim for their high quality products. India enjoys strong competitions in engineering with the advantages in design, new product development and time to market capacities. As service input for manufacturing industries expand, India with the capabilities in service sector can play a bigger role in knowledge inputs for the engineering industry. A large number of global firms are already taking advantage of these benefits by establishing their research and development centers in India. Indian Manufacturing Policy 2011 has envisaged the creation of 100 million additional jobs in the manufacturing sector by 2025. It is expected that share of manufacturing in GDP will increase to 25% by 2022. To make Indian industry productive and competitive, we must enhance our capabilities on many fronts, primarily human skill, hardware technology, and knowledge base. I strongly believe that there is another milestone to be crossed in the quality and productivity journey. New operating models would need to be considered, such as flexible automation, multi-location production, deferred customization, and disposable factories. People should be at the heart of engineering effort, reaching out to the human resources, consumers, and vendors. The contribution of manufacturing to total employment in India is about 11%, which is lower than that of many emerging economies, where the share of manufacturing in total employment is between 15 to 30%. Innovation is a key managerial strategy for growth. We must lay emphasis on its various dimensions, such as process innovation, product innovation, business model innovation, and new technology innovation.